Hello, my name is David Stark, training instructor for Case IH, and today we're out in the field with our all-new industry-leading 4400 series corn head. And I'd like to take some time here to walk you through the key features of this head. But before we start talking about some of the key features, I would first like to tell you what went into the development of this head. When we designed the new 4000 series corn head, we had three criteria that we kept in mind. First being we increased the overall picking speed of the corn head compared to our prior 3400 series, because the days of picking corn at 4 and 4.5 mile an hour are becoming a thing of the past. So we've increased the overall productivity. The second thing that we've done to this new generation of corn head is maximize the grain savings. So to get the best agronomic design out of this corn head, we've built in many features to simply put more grain in the tank and less grain on the ground. And then the third enhancement that we've made to the overall design is just improving and increasing the reliability and durability of many different components. With today's high horsepower axial flow combines and high harvest speeds, we've had to beef up gearboxes and many other components just to be prepared for the next generation of harvesting. Before we start talking about some more of the key features of this corn head, let's look at the model number. This is a 4408, which means it's a 4000 series corn head. The second 4 indicates that it's for our current feeder design, and then the 8 indicates the number of rows. If the second digit was a 2, like a 4208, that would indicate that this corn head was designed for our legacy combines, such as like a 2588. If there happened to be an F in there, that would indicate that it's folding. One of the new corn heads that we also released with the 4000 series is a folding version of the 12 row, and that's available in either chopping or non-chopping. So once again, remember the second digit being a 4 indicates it's for current feeders. If it's a 2, that indicates for legacy. And if there is an F in the model, then that indicates that it is a 12 row folding frame corn head. All right, let's take a look at some of the features now. Important to any header is the frame. The 4400 and 4200 series corn heads feature a very heavy duty frame design to ensure that if you do run the head down through a waterway or a ditch, that you don't get any cracking or flexing that could lead to damage. So the 4400 and 4200 feature an impressive 5.5 inch by 5.5 inch top beam design with fully welded construction, as you can see. Also part of the frame, you'll notice there are feet here that are used to support the header when it's disconnected. So you can simply pull this pin out, pull this pin here, and the leg will drop down. And there are different heights for different ground conditions. So you can put these feet down, it gives you a nice storage place to disconnect the header so it's not rocking forward or rocking back, which will make hooking the combine up much easier for the next time. The drive line on this header is a very robust design. First, you have 2 drive shafts that feature 60 degrees of free rotation. So that allows you to line up your splines when hooking up to the feeder house of the combine very simply. Also, moving down the drive line out to the end here, there is a double rollered chain. There's actually 2 chains in here that is driving all the row units. So it's a very heavy duty oil bath drive. Then the power is transferred to the shaft that drives all our row units. And each one of the row units is protected by a slip clutch. So for instance, if you would ingest a rock into the spirals or into the chains, you have a slip clutch on each row unit that's gonna protect all those drive components, including the chopper knives, if this was a chopping corn head. As we move around to the side of the header, behind this shield right here is the auger adjustment. So the auger on this corn head can be raised up or down as needed. So if you have an ear of corn like this and you're having the flighting causing damage, say it's cutting the ears, you may want to raise the auger up so the ears are pushing ears. Or if you're having problems with feeding, you can actually lower the auger to get more traction to bring it in. So it is fully adjustable. You just remove the shield on each side of the head, and then you can adjust by loosening four bolts. Also on the side of our head is the optional spiral end divider. And these are hydraulically driven with the speed controlled from the cab. And this is an option on this header that's very nice for when you get into, say, some of these tall corn, or, you know, we're in late November here and corn stalks are brittle. So if the corn stalk happens to get cut off, and instead of that ear falling off onto the ground, that spiral divider is going to feed that stalk right back into the corn head, saving you grain and saving you money. So it is a nice feature that it's available on all the new 4000 series corn heads. One of the biggest changes to the all new 4000 series corn head is the new poly snouts and rear hood design. And what we've got here is actually a cutaway of one of the front snouts. And you notice the prior steel framework that we used on our prior corn heads is gone. So this is a fully poly design, which will handle resistance to rolling much better than we had on our prior designs. Also, it's a very thick poly, so it's got a long wear. A lot of stalks can rub over this without causing any type of wear. And it also has some flexibility that if you do happen to run this into a ditch or into the ground, that it's not just going to roll up underneath the head and be done for. It can handle some flexing, and it has a lot of rigidity to it. So you can see the inside of this. You got the poly here and poly on the outside, and that's where it gets the double poly name from. Besides changing the construction of the new poly, we've also changed the shape. We have a much more slender profile that helps in down corn performance. The slender profile also exposes more of that gathering chain to be able to grab that down corn to get more grain into the tank. When we move back to the rear hood, notice the prior hump that was here on, say, a 3400 series has also been removed to help that crop material flow more smoothly up into the spirals, stock rolls, and up into the auger. The rear hoods on here also feature a patented corn louver design. And if you see these louvers that are built in here, these are actually to channel loose grain and ears back into the chains to prevent them from falling out of the head. Just another way that we've maximized grain savings. And remember, 2 kernels per square foot on average in your field is a bushel an acre of loss. So every kernel really does count. Now, before we move on talking about some of the other great features of this head, there are a few more things on the new poly snouts and rear hoods that we want to point out. All heads come standard with 3 wear strips. You can see one here, and then there's also one in the back there. And those are all replaceable. So if you're in high wear areas, those can simply be unbolted and replaced, saving you the cost of having to replace the whole snout or the rear hood. Another feature I do want to point out is to increase the productivity, we have increased the distance of the ear channel. So the distance from one rear divider to the second divider has been widened out to allow for more crop flow to come through when you're in those high 300 bushel plus crops of corn. One of the features that's really been improved on is just the ease of access to the row unit. With one hand, I simply lift up the front divider, automatically latches in place. Then with one hand, with my thumb, I push in and release the rear latch, pull up. I've got a nice gas strut, give me that added assistance. So you can see very easy access to that row unit to get under there to do checks or maintenance or whatever you may need to do. Now, a couple things else I'll mention before we start talking about the row unit frame is on the rear hood itself here, there's been a lot of work done to improve sealing. And by that I mean this poly seals much better to the row unit than maybe some of the prior designs and even some of the competition. And that prevents loose kernels from being pulled underneath the row unit by the gathering change, saving you more grain once again. Now when it comes to adjustability for our divider, you have a quick bale pin right here that can easily be removed, and that'll allow you to adjust that divider up and down. And then to make fine adjustments to that divider height, there is a simple draw bolt right here. So you want those dividers to be nice and even, so the crop has a nice straight flow right into the head itself. Now the row unit itself has many features to it to help you pick more corn and save more grain. One of those features are the skid shoes right here have been moved back up underneath the row unit to expose more of this gathering chain. So if you get into that down corn performance, these paddles are able to grab that down corn and bring it up into the row unit. The chains themselves are very large, so they're heavy duty design. They feature long paddles as well as tall paddles just to be able to pull more crop volume into that header. And for ease of service, these chains can easily be removed with a tool that is located on the back side of the head. So let me go ahead and grab that tool and I'll show you how easy it is to remove a gathering chain. All right, now I'm gonna go ahead and grab the tool here and it just hooks right onto the front sprocket. Latched in with one hand, I push it forward and notice how my chain can easily be pulled off if needed. So then to put it back on, I just release the tension, remove the tool, and away I go. It's a very simple design. Moving back further into the top of the chain, you have your drive sprocket that drives the chain. The gearbox that drives each row unit is a very heavy-duty design. The main gearbox is made out of an aluminum alloy for reduced header weight. For the new 4000 series corn head, the gathering chain gear sets inside that gearbox have actually been increased in strength to handle heavier loads. There have also been other improvements made in that gearbox for higher stress loads, higher productivity levels, and to handle increased chopping loads. So many improvements into the gearbox area. Another nice feature on this head is the stock rolls. And I just happen to have a stock roll laying over here, so let me go ahead and grab it. All right, let me just set that stock roll there. Now, the first thing I want to point out is it's a very large diameter. By having a large diameter, allows it to pull more crop material down at a faster rate of speed. And one of the ways that we get the productivity increase out of this header is by having optimized gear ratios. So the stock rolls on this head actually spin faster than what they would say on a prior 3400 series. Also, the timing to the gathering chain speed has been improved as well to help feeding and to prevent plugging at the rear of the row units. The drive coupler is a six-sided, very heavy-duty design to handle those high stress loads. The front of the stock roll, where the spiral bolts on, is supported by a double roller bearing. So in the tip here, there's actually two separate roller bearings to help support the front of the stock roll for all those high loads and high crop volume conditions. So very heavy duty design, very well designed agronomically to pull in crop and to save the most grain as possible. And one of the key features we don't want to forget on our 4400 series corn head is it is a pinching point stock roll design. When the knives come together, they're actually a pinching point style. So when they come together, they line up like this, compared to an intermeshing which would overlap. The pinching point style allows the stock to be positively pulled down while actually cracking open that stock material. So when that pinching point comes down, it's going to split open that stock, which is going to speed up the decay process for that next year's planting cycle. So very effective at helping reduce residue as well as improve feeding. Another feature of the row unit is the stripper plate itself. The stripper plate is fully hydraulically adjustable from inside the cab, and that is standard on all headers. Now the other side of the stripper plate is a fixed design, but can be adjusted as needed. So there are three bolts that would hold this down, and maybe you need to tighten up that gap on every row unit. Maybe you're in some drought-stricken corn, or maybe one is out of adjustment. You can adjust that fixed stripper plate to tailor this corn head to your exact harvest conditions. So that is another nice feature that will save you more grain. If this corn head was a chopping head, you would have a chopper gearbox right here. And another nice feature of the chopper gearbox is it can be individually turned on or off on each row unit as you desire. And the chopper knives feature excellent chop quality, even in tough chopping conditions such as twin row corn. That's due to the double blade design being very long and very robust for those harsh chopping conditions, which are going to help prepare that seed bed for next year's planting cycle. Moving further back into the corn head is our large 16-inch diameter auger. And like I mentioned earlier, this can be raised or lowered depending on your crop conditions from the ends of the head. Now in the center of the auger, you'll notice these flat square plates here. And these plates are designed to bolt what we call like a bear claw into if you get into some tough harvest conditions where maybe you're dealing with a lot of fluff that'll help pull that crop into there. Also part of grain savings is our ear saver shield mounted across the top here with the black flap hanging down. You can tilt that down and that will prevent ears or grain that maybe the feeder house has kicked back to prevent them from coming back out onto the header. So in most conditions I would run that door down low, but since we're late into November and the corn is very dry and fluffy, we're going to leave that more in a raised position to help let some of that dry leaf or some of that fluff flow into that feeder house nice and evenly. After viewing this video, you can see there are many new features of the 4000 series corn head that are designed to increase your overall productivity and put more grain in the tank. From us at Case IH, thanks for watching and happy harvesting.